Hello friends, today we will discuss the difference between directional and non-directional hypothesis. So let's start. Characteristics of non-directional hypothesis. A non-directional hypothesis is a type of alternate hypothesis used in statistical significance testing. A two-tailed test is a test of non-directional alternative hypothesis. It does not state the direction of the difference, it indicates only that a difference exists. Non-directional hypothesis wo alternate hypothesis hota hai jo ki two tail test mein use kiya jata hai aur ye direction of difference indicate nahi karta hai. If null hypothesis jaise ki main pata hai kehta hai ki there is no difference between mean IQs of athletes and non athletes, according to null hypothesis there is no difference between the mean of two groups, so m1 is equal to m2, or we can say that m1 minus m2 is equal to 0. So null hypothesis says that there is no difference, whereas alternate hypothesis says that there is difference exists between mean IQs of athletes and non athletes, or m1 is not equal to m2. So this is the case of non directional hypothesis. Here the hypothesis is indicating that there is only a difference exists. It is not talking about the direction or positive or negative. Characteristics of non-directional. Two-tailed test is used to indicate the non-directional hypothesis. Whether the first mean is larger or smaller, it is of no concern. No concern for the direction of difference, whether positive or negative. Here, what we are interested is to find only if there is any difference exists or not between the means. In non-directional hypothesis does not use words such as higher, lower, increase, decrease, positive or negative. There is no indication of superiority or inferiority of either of the groups. And the characteristics of directional hypothesis. Directional hypothesis indicates the direction of difference. If alternate hypothesis indicates a direction of difference, it is solved through one-tailed test. One-tailed test, it can be either be right or left. If m1 is greater than m2, then it is a case of right-tailed t-test. If m1 is less than m2, then it is a case of left-tailed t-test. For example, in case of right-tailed test, mean IQs of athletes is greater than the mean IQs of non-athletes. Whereas in case of left-tailed t-test, mean IQs of athletes is lower than that of mean IQs of non-athletes. For example, if the null hypothesis states that there is no difference between mean IQs of athletes and non-athletes, then there are three possibilities. In first case, m1 is not equal to m2. This is the case of non-directional hypothesis. There is in two other cases where m1 is less than m2 or m1 is greater than m2. This is the case of left-tailed t-test or one-tailed left-tailed. This is the case of right-tailed or one-tailed t-test. Each of these alternate hypotheses indicates a direction of difference rather than the mere existence of difference, and therefore we have to use one-tailed test, either right or left. So this is an example of directional hypothesis, and this is an example of left-tailed t-test, where m1 is less than m2 or m1 is greater than m2 in case of right-tailed t-test. Characteristics of directional hypothesis. In one-tailed test, we are concerned with the direction of difference, whether positive or negative. There is difference between means of two groups. First mean is larger or smaller than the second mean. A directional hypothesis uses words such as higher, lower, increase, decrease, positive and negative. It indicates superiority or inferiority of a group. With the help of diagram also, we can understand the concept of directional and non-directional hypothesis. Non-directional hypothesis is used in case of two-tailed tests. You can see the tails in both the directions, right as well as left. In case of left-tailed t-test, the tail is only in the left direction. Here m1 is equal less than m2. Whereas in case of right-tailed test, tail is in the right direction and m1 is greater than m2. Whereas in case of two-tailed test, non-directional hypothesis, m1 is not equal to m2. I think all of you must have understood the concept of directional and non-directional hypothesis, and all of your doubts must have been cleared. Thank you.